गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन एंड वेलकम टू द क्लास. यस्टरडे वी हैव स्टार्टेड द न्यू चैप्टर एंड द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज द क्राइसिस ऑफ डेमोक्रेटिक ऑर्डर. इन दिस चैप्टर वी हैव स्टार्टेड आवर डिस्कशन रिगार्डिंग द सिचुएशन विच वॉज प्रिवेलिंग इन द कंट्री आफ्टर द फिफ्थ जनरल इलेक्शन. We have discussed the result of the fifth general election, and we have seen that in the fifth general election and in the state assembly's election, the Congress was again returned to its dominant position, which was called by many as the restoration of Congress system. And but we have seen that actually it was not the restoration of the Congress system, because in this new Congress what we find that the nature of the Congress was changed completely. And now we are seeing that the general election of 1970 and the assembly's election of 1971 were won by the Congress that is the Congress of Indira Gandhi, and so many promises were made by the Prime Minister Mrs. Indira Gandhi, and the main slogan was remove poverty. But what we find that what actually happened after this election, that the economy was in very bad condition, and there were some reasons for the economy to go in such a bad condition. The first and the most important reason was the war with Pakistan in the year 1971. So not only war, but the Bangladesh crisis. Because of the Bangladesh crisis, what happened that around 8 million refugees entered India, and so this was a grave challenge for the government of India. So these two were the reason for the deterioration in the economic condition of the country. Then we find that the US has also stopped giving aid to India because of this war. And not only this, during this period, in 1973-74, there was Arab-Israel war. And because of this Arab-Israel war, what happened, the oil prices were rising very sharply. And this rise in the price of oil led to the rise in the price of the essential commodities. And we have seen that in the year 1973, the price increased by 23%, and in the year 1974, the price increased by 30%. So this was the condition. Not only this, we find that industrial growth was also very low, and unemployment was also rising at a very high speed. Okay, and we see that the government was facing the challenge of economic crisis, and in order to solve this problem, what was done by the government, that it froze the salaries of its employees. And because of this froze of salary of the government employees, it caused a lot of dissatisfaction among the government employees. So these are the problems. I will write it down first. The first problem which the country was facing at that time was the reason for crisis was
Bangladesh
Bangladeshi refugees. These are the reasons for economic crisis. And the second is Indo-Pak war. The third is US stopped giving aid. Then the fourth one is sharp price in oil prices. These are all the reasons for the economic crisis that was prevailing in the country. Then fifth is low industrial output. Then sixth is increasing unemployment. These are the reasons because of which the country was facing acute economic crisis. And in order to solve the economic crisis, what was done by the government, that it froze the salary of government employees. And then again one problem, a new reason for the economic crisis was the failure of monsoon. Okay, so because of this failure of monsoon, there was the agricultural output jo hai wo decrease karta hai. Okay, so because of all these problems, the economy was in a very great crisis. And in order to solve the problem, what was done by the government, that was also causing a lot of dissatisfaction among the people, especially among the government employees. And we see that there was an atmosphere of dissatisfaction among the people, and the opposition party took advantage of this situation. They started organizing public protest. They started to mobilize the people against the government. Okay, and other than this, we also see that this was the time when the Marxist group of the Communist Party of India also became very active. They started to armed rebellion, type of armed rebellion, and in this the group which was on the focus of this Marxist group was the group of peasants, and these Marxists are called Naxalites, and they are very much active at that time in West Bengal. And the government has taken many measures, to strict measures, to stop the activities of the Marxist group. And then we find that we have discussed about the two major states which were the happenings of the two major states, and these were Gujarat and Bihar. And we have seen that in these two states there was government was of Congress, and there was a high level of dissatisfaction among the people. And the cause of dissatisfaction was
price rise. First of all, we are seeing the happenings of
Gujarat, the price rise, the essential commodities were rising, the price of essential commodities were rising at a very high speed. Not only this, corruption at high level was also one of the reason for the movement. And the movement, the protest was first started by the students,
and which took the form of movement. And then we see that various
political parties, the opposition parties, joined the movement of the students. And in this we have seen that Morarji Desai, he was the he became the leader of this students movement, and he demanded that there must be, the situations must be improved. And then what we see, because of these movements and these unrest, what was done by the government? The government imposed president's rule in Gujarat. But after, because of this imposition of president's rule, what happened that the movement and the dissatisfaction, the level of dissatisfaction has risen up. And now the students and the political leaders were demanding that the president's rule must be ended and fresh elections must be done in Gujarat. And the government was under pressure. The government accepted the demand of the opposition party, because Morarji Desai, he has given, he has warned the government that if the press elections are not conducted, then he will go on an indefinite strike, indefinite fast. Okay, so this kind of pressure was there over the government, and the central government decided to hold fresh elections in Gujarat. So the elections were held in June 1975, and the result was the Congress was defeated. So after this Gujarat, we will see the condition or the happenings of the state of Bihar. In Bihar also, the movement of the people was actually started by the students, and the time was March 1974.
The time was March. And what was the reason of a student's movement was price rise, as
the same reason was there in Gujarat also. So this price rise was the main reason of the movement. And other than this, other problems were also there, like unemployment,
then food scarcity, and corruption.
These were the reasons for the movement of the students, which started in Bihar in March 1974. So the students started the movement on their own, and the movement was growing day by day. But after a point, it was felt that this movement needed a leader, and this because of this feeling, what happened that Jai Prakash Narayan, JP,
okay, Jai Prakash Narayan was invited by these students to lead their movement. Okay, so
Jai Prakash Narayan was invited to lead the movement, and by this time Jai Prakash Narayan has given up active politics. Now he was not in the active politics, and he has committed his life towards social work. Instead of being active in politics, he was now active in social work. And when the students invited him for leadership, he accepted the invitation, but he put one condition. Two conditions were put by Jai Prakash Narayan. The first condition was that the movement should remain non-violent. There should not be any kind of use of violence in the movement. So this was the first condition of Jai Prakash Narayan. And the second condition which was put by Jai Prakash Narayan was that this movement should not be limited to Bihar only. It means that this movement should grow, should expand on the basis of all India basis. So these two conditions were put by Jai Prakash Narayan, and the students accepted the demand of Jai Prakash Narayan, and then we see that the student movement now it took a political character. Now it was because the leader Jai Prakash Narayan was leading the movement, so now it has taken a political character. And we see that it was not only confined to Bihar, but the message was that this movement was for the whole country, not only for the people of Bihar, but for the whole country. And we see that people from all the people from different walks of life entered the movement. Okay, and the support base of the movement was increasing day by day. The number of people who were involved in the movement was increasing. And then we see that Jai Prakash Narayan, he demanded that the Congress government which was there in Bihar, that government should be dismissed. And in this situation, he gave a call for total revolution. Total revolution means that this movement is not only for the economic purpose. Okay, total revolution means that the this movement, the purpose of this movement is to make changes in the economic life, in the social life, in the political life. Okay, so that we can establish a true drum of democracy, because whatever democracy was there at that time in India, according to Jai Prakash Narayan, that democracy was not a true democracy. So because the democracy was not true, that is why people were facing so much problem. The common people were not able to purchase the basic needs of their life. They were not able to fulfill the basic needs of their life because they were the prices of basic commodities were rising so high. There was food scarcity, there was unemployment, there was corruption. So this was not democracy. So what was the need of the time? The need of the time was to establish a true democracy, and this was demanded by Jayaprakash Narayan. That it was called total revolution by him.
The name given to this was
total revolution. Okay, so we see that this total revolution means that there should be true democracy in all spheres of life, like true democracy democracy in all spheres of life,
social, political, and economic.
So this was the demand of Jayaprakash Narayan, and he was also demanding that the Congress government, which was there in Bihar, that government should also be dismissed. And then we see that the movement of this movement started to grow at a very high rate, and the people started organizing bands, then dharna, Gherao, strikes. So all these methods were adopted by the people in order to put pressure on the government. And the government, the state government, was under high pressure because people were protesting so much. They were doing dharnas, they were doing Gherao, they were doing strikes, but still the state government was not ready to resign. It was not ready to leave the position of the power. And then we see that the movement started to influence the politics at the national level. Now Jayaprakash Narayan, he wanted that the movement which was started in Bihar should spread to the whole country, as it was his condition, one of the conditions when he joined the students movement as leader. So now he wanted to give it a the form of the nationwide movement. And at this time we see that the situation in the country was very bad, because not only this movement of students were going on in Gujarat and Bihar only, the condition other sectors were also very bad. And in this regard we will see the condition which was prevailing in the Indian Railway. At that time what we find that there were some demands of the railway employees, and these demands were regarding the bonus and service conditions of the railway employees. And the government was not ready to accept these demands of bonus and improving the service conditions. And because of this refusal of their demand by the government, what happened that in the same year, in 1974, there was a union of railway workers. The name of the union was National Coordination Committee for Railway Men's Struggle. So this national coordination committee for railway men's struggle, this union
national coordination committee for railway men's struggle. This was the union of
railway workers, railway staff, and the leader was George Fernandez. So, in the leadership of George Fernandez, what happened that this National Coordination Committee, they called for nationwide strike. All the employees of the railway, they gave a call for a nationwide strike. And we can just imagine the condition. If the railway goes on strike, then it will cause a lot of trouble for the people, because they will not be able to travel. As we saw just now, in this COVID-19 situation, we have experienced what kind of situation arise when there is when the movement of railways are stopped, and not only the people will be troubled. The other main problem which will generate from this strike would be the loss to economy. Because our economy is very much dependent on the railway for the transportation of the goods. So in this this was the situation which was prevailing at that time, and there was a call was given by the railway employees that they will go on strike. But still the government was not ready to accept their demands. And what happened that they actually went on a strike. In May 1974, the railway employees went on a strike. And the result of this strike was no movement of railways. So the government started to occur so much loss. And we see that this strike this strike also inspired other labor unions to raise their voice, to adopt this way of strike, so that the government can be put under the pressure. But what was done by the government when this strike was started? The government declared that this strike was illegal, and the government was still not ready at all to accept the demand of the railway employees. And now the it was done by the government that the strike was started to be suppressed. The strike was started to be crushed by the government, because it started to arrest many of the leaders of this strike. Many leaders were arrested, and not only this, but the government also deployed army in order to protect the railway tracks. And we see that the strike went on for 20 days. The strike went on for 20 days, and after 20 days, because the government was taking strict actions, so the strike could not be continued, and without any settlement, there was no settlement. The purpose of strike was to put pressure on the government so that it should so that it will accept the demand of the railway staff. But what we find that the strike started and for 22 days the strike was there, but still the government was not ready to accept the demand. And we see that the strike was called off by the union without any settlement, without any achievement. The strike had to call off. So this kind of situation was prevailing in the years of 1974 and 75, and we will discuss other things in the next class.